nights. Amen. Amen. Certainly thankful for what the Lord did this morning. Glad and thankful to be back tonight. Thankful that Sequoia's come to be with us and worship with us tonight and brought their instruments. Here's what we're going to do tonight. It's not, maybe not traditional in a lot of places, but we're just going to obey the Lord because that's the only way to go to church. I think we're going to sing some congregationals, and then somebody's got a special to sing, we're going to sing. There's about five or six preachers in here tonight, so I've done told them if they feel like they need to preach, we'll just preach. If you got a testimony on your heart, tonight's the night to obey the Lord, and I believe that He can birth revival from it, but He needs us to be obedient. Let's pray before we get started and ask the Lord to meet with us. Father, I thank You for the opportunity once again to be in this place. I thank You, Lord, for what You did in our hearts this morning and for the Spirit of God that You allowed us to feel. Lord, I thank You for this time to come and to worship. And Lord, I pray that You'd guide and direct everything that we do, every song we sing, Lord, every word that might be spoken or, Father, a word that might be preached tonight. I pray that it would be for Your honor and for Your glory. I pray that You would tune our hearts to sing Your praise and to worship You tonight. Lord, I pray that You'd bind the enemy and that the Spirit of God would move up and down these aisles and, Lord, would stir up that fire that's shut up in our bones, that, Lord, we couldn't help but keep from singing and we couldn't help but keep from worshiping You tonight. Lord, for whoever needs to testify, I pray that they do it. For whoever needs to sing, I pray that they would do it. Lord, that we would leave here edified and encouraged in Jesus' name. Amen.
Welcome to Black Oak Baptist Church. All right, here's what we're going to do. If you're a part of a choir, either at Sequoia or at Black Oak, you come on up. We're going to go ahead and get started. We're going to sing some old songs. Brother Dan and Isaac and Brother Lance are going to come up and play some instruments with us, and we're going to do some old-fashioned gospel songs to start off with. Hey, when you drag the preacher up in the choir, you better come up and sing. Right? When you drag him up in the choir, you better come up and sing. Yeah, amen. Now, hey, we'll probably mess up. There's probably some of these old songs some of these new folks won't know all about, but we'll overlook all that. All we're here to do is worship and praise the Lord. So you stand with us. We're going to sing about three songs, then we're going to step out and shake hands, and we'll go from there. First song is Well Done, My Child. Well Done, My Child. We'll give these guys. Everybody knows that. Amen. There you go.
Thank you.
remember that in a minute. We're going to sing a couple songs. Then after that, if you got a song, we're just going to invite you to come on up. Miss Jean, you going to sing? You going to sing after that? All right. Brother Kevin, I know you're going to sing. And then Brother Lance, you guys, just get ready. Okay? So we'll just go from here. We're going to sing a couple songs. This has been requested. If you've got a song you want us to try to sing tonight, this man will play it. I guarantee you that. And you just throw it up there and we'll try to go through it. Ready?
Times I question certain circumstances, things I could not understand. Many times in trials, weakness blurs my vision. That's when my frustration gets so out of hand. Oh, it's then I am reminded I've never been forsaken. I've never had a standard test alone. So look at all the victories, the Spirit rises up in me, and it's through the fire my weakness is made strong.
He never promised that the cross would not be heavy.
Trust the mighty hand of God to shield the flame again, again.
He never promised that the cross would not be heavy and the hill will not be hard to climb. He never offered a victory without fighting. He said help would always come in time. Just in the valley of decision, the adversary says, give in, just hold on. Our Lord will show up, and he will take you through the fire again. Just hold on. Our Lord will show up, and he will take you through the fire.
supposed to be first tonight. Brother Kev, you want to start us? Come on, brother.
Precious memories, unseen angels sent from somewhere to my soul. How they linger ever near me. Sacred past unfolds. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the still precious Father, loving Mother, fly across the lonely years, and old home scenes of my childhood in from memory appears. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred scenes unfold.
Say this, we elected Brother Lance in as our pastor this morning, and just pray for him and pray for our little church that that we'll just continue to try to be alive. That's all we do.
Amen.
But I'd like to say something. I'm glad I'm saved.
Amen.
The above everything else in this world.
Right?
That's right.
About a year ago, my wife died. And I curled up in a little ball. And I just wanted to leave here. But I'm glad that God's got grace. And God's got mercy. And every time that I reach out to Him, whether it was the middle of the night, whether it was during the day, whether I just snuck off somewhere, He was right there, Mark. I didn't have to hunt Him down. I didn't have to do all these things. And He taught me how to get up every day and put one foot in front of the other. Not worry about tomorrow. He said this, and I doubted it. I've preached the Word since 1984. And I've doubted very little in my life till I got to the part to where He said, my grace is sufficient for His need. But I want to tell you something. If He offers grace and you don't take it, you won't receive it. But I had to get to a point in my life to where I was broken enough to where I could receive the grace that God was offering me. But when I done that, you know what? There was help.
Yep.
I'm glad of that at you. I'm glad I've got more than this world to look forward to. I've got a better land waiting on me. Not because of who I am, not because of who my daddy was. Because September 10th, 1972, in Island Ford Baptist Church, I heard a knock on my heart's door. And as a little boy, I got up and I made my way to an altar and I prayed the simplest prayer, the only one I knew. I said, Lord, if you don't save me, I'll die and go to hell. And you know what? He took me in just like you would have Billy Graham. He's loved me and He's been a God to me. And you know what? David said this. He said, I was once young and I'm now old. He said, I've never seen the righteous forsaken or God's seed begging bread.
Yes, sir.
And if you want to eat tonight, just move up to the table.
Right.
Because it's here. And I'm thankful tonight that it's here. And like I said, the best thing that ever happened to me, I love my kids. I love my wife. But the best thing that ever happened to me was that morning that Jesus saved my soul.
Amen.
Right.
There's a day just out in front of us. I know we'll surely come. That Easter sky. Oh,
One cold You're my comfort in time of need.
Yes.
You're my refuge and you're my rock.
Yeah.
You're the one I depend on. You're the road to hope when the light grows dim, when the waves of doubt come crashing in. You're my anchor in a troubled storm, Almighty God.
Yes.
You're my joy, you're my peace. You're my comfort in time of need. You're my refuge, you're my rock. You're the one I depend on. You're the road to hope when the light grows dim, when the waves of doubt come crashing in. You're my anchor in a troubled storm, Almighty God. Now you bore the cross and you bear the scars.
Right.
You're my bright and shining star. You gave me sight that I might see the kind of man that I should be. And you died to set me free, Almighty God.
Because
you're my joy, you're my peace. You're my comfort in time of need.
Right.
You're my refuge, you're my rock. You're the one I depend on. You're the road to hope when the light grows dim, when the waves of doubt come crashing in. You're my anchor in a troubled storm, Almighty God.
Amen.
Lance wants me to sing an old one. I don't know if I remember it all.
He still got his throat left. Let him sing.
They whip me up the hill, promise I am the man. They made me carry my cross, Thomas, I am the man.
Thank you, man.
I am the man, old Thomas, I am the man. Look at these nail scars here in my hand. They crowned my head with thorns, Thomas, I am the man. They nailed me to that cross, Thomas, I am. I am the man, old Thomas, I am the man. Look at these nail scars here in my hand. They pierced me in my side, Thomas, I am the man. I hung there and I died, Thomas, I am the man. I am the man, old Thomas, I am the man. Look at these nail scars here in my hand. They laid me in a tomb, Thomas, I am the man. In 3 days I arose, Thomas, I am the man. I am the man, oh, Thomas, I am the man. Look at these nail scars here in my hand.
Put Child of the King up there. We'll sing that one next. Isaac's got that on his heart.
I'll try to remember this song Roger asked me to sing.
I don't remember how to play it, but Rocky, I'm sure, will follow me, and you help me if I forget the words. I'm glad for the Lord still meeting with us, aren't you? Amen. Amen. There's a room. Help me with that. Help me get that started. And shoes on my feet, you gave me your love, and a fine family. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. Let's go to the second verse. For I know I'm not wealthy, and these clothes, they're not new. I don't have much money, but Lord, I have you. And to me, that's all that matters, though the world may not see. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. For there's a roof up above me, I've a good place to sleep. There's food on my table and shoes on my feet. You gave me your love, Lord, and a fine family. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. Put that first verse up there, if you will. I want you to think about it tonight. We're just here to worship. I'm just here to say that I'm thankful for all that he's done for me. You sing this. Think about it tonight. Your car's already in the parking lot. You might as well worship while you're here. As the world looks upon me, as I struggle along, they say I have nothing, but they how I wish they could see. Thank you, Lord, for your blessings on me. Amen. Are you thankful for his blessings tonight? Amen. Amen. You had a child of a king on your heart?
Compassion, love. this song in my possession for quite a number of years now, and Haley and I used to sing it together at Zion Hill. And I got this song not too long after my dad had passed away, and it's been 18 years this year, and he was a pastor of Zion Hill Baptist Church, and he had cancer, and he was still young, in my opinion, when the Lord took him out, but he went out praising God. His last words as I stood by his bedside were, "My Lord and God." I watched as he passed from death unto life, and I can't wait, because one day after a while I'll get to see him again. He won't be riddled with cancer anymore. He'll have a new glorified body, and I'm thankful for that tonight. And I praise God for that, because I believe in Jesus, and I believe in a place called heaven. And I believe, because Jesus shed his blood for me and I accepted him as my Lord and Savior, that I'll inherit one day that kingdom. And y'all, if you know the song, sing with me, because my little sidekick's not here tonight. Y'all pray for me.
When I see the sun rise in the morning, when I feel the wind blow across my face, when I hear the sound of children play, I know it's all part of God's amazing grace, and I believe there's a place called heaven, and I believe in a place called his soul away to be crowned at Jesus' feet. And I believe there's a place called heaven, and I believe in a place
God sent his son. They call him Jesus. He came to love, heal, and forgive. He lived and died to buy my pardon. An empty grave is there to prove my sin.
We're going to sing another song. Stand and worship with us on this song right here. We've sung all about God tonight. Did you truly know how great our God is tonight? Right? We need to lift up our hands sometimes. Give him thanks. He's the splendor of our world. Everything he does, created by him above. Worship him tonight.
Splendor of the King.
because he loves me. Right?
That's
amen.
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Sing because he loves me. Amen. Amen. There you go.
Thank you. appreciate the opportunity the Lord's given us to be in His house tonight. And we'll be honest with you, we didn't come prepared not to do anything special. But I always go to the Lord's house prepared to do what He had me to do. Might not mean much to nobody else, but it sure means a lot to me. And it means a lot to Him that we care enough about Him to do what He'd have us to do. But I thought as they sung the song tonight, "Because He Lives, I Can Face Tomorrow." And I thought tonight that I have no idea what tomorrow may bring. But I don't worry about tomorrow because of what I done a long time ago. Had a little bitty old country church in Andersonville when I gave my life to a risen Savior. And you think it might not mean much, but I tell you tonight, I just got to share this with you for whatever reason. Back in May of 2015, everything was fine in our life. No troubles whatsoever that we knew of. Everything was just good, Danny. We went to the doctor and things changed. My wife was diagnosed with breast cancer. And the day before, we thought everything was fine. But because He lives, 8 years later, everything's just fine.
Amen. Amen.
Just fine. Sure, we have troubles. We have trials and we have heartaches. But because He lives, I can face tomorrow.
Amen.
Can you do that tonight? Can you? Because He lives. I want you to sing it again. You say, we done sung that, and I'll be honest with you, it don't get old to me.
Amen.
What God done for me don't get old.
Amen.
And I don't know what you're accustomed to. I'll be honest, I've never been here in my life. Jeff invited me, tried to go a different direction, and the Lord wouldn't let me. Told me to come on down here, and I did, and I'm glad I came. He's invited me several times, and I always had some reason I couldn't. I told my wife, I said, I have no reason I can't go. So I came tonight, but I want Him to sing it again. I ain't no singer, I promise you that. But I want Him to sing it again. Whoever sung it a few minutes ago, sing it again. Because He lives, I want you to stand up tonight, and I want you to think about it as you sing it. Search your heart out tonight. If trouble comes your way tomorrow, will it still be all right in your soul? If death comes tomorrow, Lance, we thought Gerald might live a long time, but he didn't. What if death comes down your trail tomorrow? Would everything be all right in your life? I went to hear this young man. I'll be honest with you. I'm going to confess to him tonight and to you. I went to revival at Sequoia Baptist Church one night. Hoping to hear Isaac or his brother-in-law in that preach. Had no intentions of hearing this man. Didn't know him. Didn't want to hear him. But he got up and he began to preach the Word of God. And you know what happened? It was a connection made. Huh? You know what that connection was? It was the Holy Ghost. I say, I believe in the Holy Ghost, whether you do or not.
Amen.
I believe in that. I had a preacher friend one time tell me, I said, I don't believe in ghosts. He said, what about the Holy Ghost?
Yeah.
And I had to recant my statement and change that. But tonight I tell you, God can help you tonight. He wants to help you.
Amen.
See, that's what the Bible says, you come to seek and to save that which was lost.
Amen.
I'm glad I got lost.
Yeah. Amen.
I didn't have to come sign my name. I didn't have to come give no money. I gave my heart to Him. That's what I done. I can't tell you what I said. I don't know that I said anything. I believe at the very hour that God convicted my heart, I stepped out.
Amen.
See, preacher, I can't change. I couldn't either. Couldn't change. But because He lives, I change, Lance. See, I serve a risen Savior tonight. He just... They put Him in a grave and they rolled a rock in front of Him and laid their body down. Put guards out there and they said, you watch Him and you make sure that He don't go nowhere. The Bible teaches us a great earthquake come by and the stone was rolled away.
Amen.
When that stone got rolled away, they looked inside and Jesus was nowhere to be found.
Amen.
See, I'm telling you right now, he said, you tear this temple down, and in 3 days I'll rear it back up. He's just speaking of himself. Never dreamed in a million years that cancer would come to our home. A big old crybaby when it comes to this. I can't help it. We got in our living room floor. As far as I could go with her. You know what he said when he saved you? He said, I'll go with you always, even to the end.
Right.
He made that statement come true in our life that day. We went to had all these surgeries and everything and all these treatments. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow.
Right.
All fear is gone.
Right.
My wife said, I don't like going nowhere. I get nervous. I don't know anybody. I'll be honest with you. Somebody here know my wife. She don't speak with my physical. I'm the one that's back with the wife. I don't like to talk to her. But you know what? I asked him what I want to say. He put something inside me that never will tell anybody. I'm going to let you know about me named Jesus.
Right.
And then he called me to preach, and I thought, Lord God, I can't do that. And you know what? I can't. I can't preach a lick and that without him. That if you was to die right now, that heaven would be your home. This lady don't know me from Adam, probably, but her daddy was a great help to me. He see me at the Burger King, the glove on me. Nothing too bad and too hard, my Lord, can't it?
Right.
Nothing. You say, preacher, he can't save no sinner like me. Let me tell you something right now. I wasn't the worst person in the whole wide world. I hadn't done a whole lot wrong. Ago. And I tell you, people tell us to raise our hands and praise, and we'll do all that. come by and he'll tell us to do something and we just... He's the one that died for you. He's the one that sent his son for you. I'm going to hush now. I just want to tell you that. I don't know. Like I said, I've never been here. I come from a little place. We just like to have church.
Amen.
We like to shout. We like to run around a little bit every now and then.
Amen.
We just like to praise the Lord, man. He's worthy of our praise.
Right. Sing his song. These altars are open. If you got something you need help with tonight, you can face it because he lives. This might be the last thing God have us do tonight. I don't know, but would you respond if he deals with your heart tonight? Would you take this opportunity to get before him just like you did in that living room floor? Maybe right here, that'd be for you. Say, Lord, I need you to take care of this for me. Maybe tonight you don't have the assurance of your salvation. Maybe tonight you'd get around an old-fashioned altar. Let one of us take a Bible and show you about what he can do for you. And then, Brother Don, one day you'll know when you cross that river and you fought the battle and you've run the race that everything will be all right. Do you have that assurance tonight? You know you're going to heaven when you die. This could be your last opportunity. Would you respond? Let's sing it tonight.
God sent his son.
Would you just obey the Lord tonight?
They call him Jesus.
About it. Don't just sing it. Think about it.
He lived and died.
Are you glad? Just for you, friend.
By my pardon, an empty grave is there to prove my Savior lived.
Are you glad that he's alive?
Way to victory, I'll see.
because he's alive.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Brother Lance, I ask myself often in these moments what to do next. Because I have no idea. I just want to do what the Lord wants. Anybody else feel the Lord's put something on your heart before we go home tonight? What a day that'll be. Amen. I've never seen the face of my Savior, and I've never seen the gates of that city, but I can tell you what, one day I will. Amen. Anybody else have anything on your heart tonight before we go home? Anybody else got something on your heart tonight? Thank you. right. That's right. Amen. That's all right. That's right. Amen. Amen. Right. Thank you. feel this on my heart tonight, and we'll go home. You might say, preacher, what's happened tonight's emotionalism. No, it's not. You just haven't tasted what we've tasted. This, I don't believe, Brother Lance, I'm going to preach in heaven, but I believe I'm going to worship in heaven for all of eternity. Tonight, we're just obeying the Lord, what He wants. But I feel this in my spirit, and then we're going home tonight. I can feel somebody in this place needs to make a decision. Preacher, how do you feel that? I can't explain it. You know what I'm talking about. But I can feel tonight that somebody needs the Lord. I feel in my spirit tonight that somebody needs to be saved. And I believe the Lord wants to give you one more opportunity before you leave. Romans 5 and 8 said, but He commended, He demonstrated His love toward us. And while we were yet sinners, that Christ died for us. That He that knew no sin became sin for us, so that we could be made into the righteousness of God in Him. Brother Isaac, when I had no strength, in due time, Christ died for the ungodly. Friend, He's your only hope tonight. He's your only hope of heaven. He's your only hope of the life to come, and He's your only hope here. I wonder tonight, do you feel that knock on your heart? Do you feel that tug inside of you tonight? Maybe you need to make a decision tonight. Maybe you're here and you haven't got help this whole time, and maybe you need help from the Lord. Let's sing one more song if you got one, Brother Roger. I want to have a song of invitation, and then we're going to go home tonight. Whatever you got on your heart. Tonight, would you come? Maybe you need help. Would you come? You say, preacher, I don't know I'm going to heaven when I die, but there's something stirring inside of me. Would you come? It might be your last opportunity.
In sin's dark valley,
but you could leave tonight knowing that you got hope.
No hope within.
Christians are praying. Somebody here needs help.
I see.
Would you just pray that they'd step out?
They search through hell. To save a poor lost soul like me. Oh, what a Savior. Oh, hallelujah. His heart was broken.
Bother me when it comes my way. Are you ready tonight?
Blood for even me.
help from the Lord tonight, say amen. Amen. How many of you'd like to do this again? Amen. Amen. We got some more Fifth Sundays coming up this year, so we might just need y'all to come back, or maybe next time we'll come to your place and we'll do it. I appreciate you guys coming. You make sure you tell them you're glad that they came, and you pray for them in the days ahead. Amen. Gerald had a great impact on my life. Every time I walked in Sequoia Missionary Baptist Church and sat on the front pew, I knew I better be ready to preach. He'd point at me and say, "It's you." Amen. Amen. Well, I'm thankful for the Lord tonight. Don't forget all the announcements, all that we've got coming up. Don't forget to listen to your phone tree. We got a lot coming up. And don't forget about Wednesday, our business meeting, our prayer service, and then regular services on Sunday. I'm not going to close in prayer, because that's something Gerald always said not to do. He said, let's carry out what we've got into this week. So you do that tonight. You are dismissed at liberty to go. Thank you for being here. Make sure you shake these men's hand. Tell them you're glad they came.